Hello everyone, welcome back. Gene here with another video. This time it's a little bit of a change up. I'm going to be doing a video on the 1964 Impala Coupe. I had a Facebook friend ask me if I happen to have a pattern or a layout for the body side molding trim holes for these cars, and I don't. And I've replaced a number of panels for this car, so I'm going to go ahead and lay these out and video it, post it, and see if it's of any value to folks. So if you're interested, take a look and let me know if you need any more information on this, and I'll see what I can do to help. So here we go. Okay, so here's the 64 Impala Coupe, not an SS. This is not an SS. I'm going to repeat that a bunch of times. So what I did was I replaced that fender with a new aftermarket. I replaced that door, new aftermarket, and I did some repairs on that quarter panel. So as you can see, the trim holes are on that quarter panel. They're not on that door, and they're not on that fender. Now if we walk around to the other side, which is going to be a little bit tougher to video, but I'll do my best. This is an original fender. And if you can see it, the trim holes are still in that. So I'll explain that as we go along. Okay, so I replaced that door with an aftermarket door, and I replaced that whole quarter with an aftermarket quarter. So there's no body molding trim holes on this quarter, that door, but there are on that fender. So what does all this mean? Well, I need to line all the trim holes and drill them where I don't have them. And many other folks are in the same boat. And I've seen online numerous people trying to find a pattern template of the trim holes. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to take some of the spare sheet metal fenders, etc., that I have left over, and take measurements on those parts. This old door, this rusted out door, and then this fender. And I'm using this fender because this is a coupe fender, and this is an SS fender. And I can't use that for, I'm going to swing around real quick here. Those holes right there are not on an SS fender. As you can tell, when I walk over here, since this is an SS fender, there are no holes down here because that one does not have a trim piece on it for an SS. So, what do we have here? So those two fenders are going to be for my wagon, which is out there. This door is going to be scrapped out, but I needed to save it, like I said, for the trim holes. And that will complete all the trim hole measurements once I go through this process. I should have all of them and then go ahead and lay them out on the car. So that's what we're doing today. Wish me luck. Okay, so the first thing I'm doing is I'm going to number all those trim holes on the quarter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, all the way up to 25. Those are just the molding trim holes. Then after that, I'll go ahead and draw some straight lines and take some measurements between each one of them. Then after that, what I'll do is I'll figure out a way to get the emblems measured out. and with the understanding that this is the right side, so once you go to the other side of the quarter panel, you got to flop this thing around and change the letters, because it would be backwards if you did it on the other side. I know I don't have to say that, but I thought I would. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do first, and let's see how this goes. Okay, let's get the chalk line out. I'll tell you, these bad boys are not even, but '60-year-old car, you're gonna have that. It flexes over the years. So we're gonna go ahead and I think I'm gonna put another magnet right here. Those look really good. These are a little low. This one's perfect. This one's perfect. Let's bring this up. Let's see what we get. Not perfect right there. You like it? I like it. Let's see if I can do this without fucking up. This is perfect. This is a little high. Let's go with it. Okay. So that one's a little high. Those look really good. Thank you. these ones are gonna be pretty funky. Like I say, these ones are gonna be kind of funky because I've replaced this and this. So let's cross our fingers and see how good those turn out. Yeah, I like that. Except this isn't tight enough. This one's pretty tight. Let's do this first. Wow, not bad. Okay, I like that. So we gotta get number 13 done. It's gotta be really pretty precise because this piece has gotta fit real nice. I've seen a lot of Impalas where this C, whatever we call it, does not line up well. So let's see if we can get this one real precise. How are we gonna do that? Put that on the 1-inch line, so I have a nice big line. It's right at 5, so from the bottom up, we're at 4 inches on the balls. Now, this way. So I'm going to go grab another ruler here and get the center of that one. Shouldn't use this. Thank you. inches, 2 3/8. That should do that one. So if you guys don't have one of these types of tape measures, I highly recommend it. I use these a lot of different things. They really don't stretch. I mean, over a long distance they will, but over a foot, 2 foot, they're pretty nice. So anyways, I like to use these. And then you can put a magnet on them and hold them on there on surfaces that aren't quite flat. So here we go. Okay, so let's talk about this corner. Seam, whatever you want to call it. This is not going to be exact, what I'm giving you right here. So you're going to have to use your judgment, because this may be bent, old, whatever, in, out. It's not going to be perfect on every car. So if I get a really precise measurement here, you're just going to have to understand that you're going to have to use your judgment. Because when we do this side, you know, obviously it's going to be coming out some, so they're going to be a little bit different. But anyways, just use your judgment on this spot right here. So I got exactly 7 inches here. So you may be off by 16th or, you know, depending on what this corner is, so just be wary. Let's go down the line here. Okay, so let's go down the line here. So this one's at 7, this one's at 11 and an 8, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and an 8. Okay, so this one's 8 and 13 sixteenths. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 and 3 quarters. 8 7 eighths minus 16th. 13 sixteenths. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 13 sixteenths. I think. And then I'm going to go down through all these and do it that way. You probably don't need to watch me film all that. So let's see how we do. Okay, there's the top line of the quarter panel. Let's see if we can get some close-in shots for folks. That's a 12. obviously. Okay, we'll do the bottom next. Okay, I don't like how I did that one. I'm gonna redo it. See if I can get this thing here. Right on the center. Between these two. Okay, I feel better about that. Now let's measure it. Two and five sixteenths. So I was 1/16 off. There, you can almost read that. Okay. Now let's put on and start measuring these ones. Okay, this looks like a nice spot to measure the up and down. It's nice and straight, not been beat up by me. This one looks pretty good too. Let's do it. Right here, this is the important one. And it's exactly a half inch. Okay, so what do I mean by that? So if you replaced quarter panels, doors, fenders, when you're matching your body lines got to go from the back of the car to the front of the car. Quarter panels don't move once they're on, so everything from the quarter panel forward needs to match the body line. So you match up your door to your quarter panel, and then your fender to the door. When you do that, I'm gonna walk over there, back out some. So when you're setting your body lines, coming this way, and when you got a nice body line here, then you set your door. This door is obviously low, but it's okay, I haven't done anything with it yet. This door's got to come up to here. When you set your door and you get your body line nice and straight, going this way, nail it. Then do the same thing with your fender. Get your fender going in, out, up, down, get your gaps, etc. But this body line, when you have your trim on, this body line's got to be lined up all the way down. So that's why these holes got to be measured off of there and straight. So when you put your trim on, and your body line shows, and I'll put a piece of trim on later, your body line shows straight across, and your trim straight across. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, make sure this half inch looks good, and I'm going to go down somewhere in here, do a half inch, and then do a half inch, maybe a couple of them. One, two, check my half inches in three or four places. I like it. Okay, looks great. Okay, so while we're here, let's check this. one half. Just for the fun of it.
Check this one.
Same, it's one half. Okay, now I'll take some photos of it and I'll make sure that I have plenty of photos that you can actually read the numbers. This is just a pretty grainy video here, so. Okay, so we're going to do the holes for this emblem right here. This is the one with the deer in it. So I marked the centers. And I marked the centers of these two guys because that's the only thing decent I could go off of. And I'm going to use the flexible tape because trying to get a tape and going this way would be impossible. Well, not impossible, but I can't do it. So, let's do it. One, two, three, four. Three quarter, minus 16th. Looks like 11 16ths. Four, 11 16ths. This is 1, 2, 7/8. This one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3/4. 2 3/4. So they're 1/8 off. And I will check the emblem to find out if that's to get it leveled. 2 3/4. Yeah, let's do these. Let's check it. 4 1/5 8. Correct. Check this one. 1 2 1/8. Let's check it. 2 5/8. Check this one. Let's check this one again. What the hell? Sixteenths. Let's check it again. 1 9/16. Okay, that's it. Please check my measuring. I'm gonna put my magnet up here. Then I'll put it right here. No, I'll put it right here. I'm actually gonna put it upside down so you can see the numbers. I'll magnet it up there. Then anybody can check me when I take a photo of it. Put this one right. There you go. Don't play with that. Pop these off. Thank you. Love potion. Damn. I don't like that. Okay, I've got the door laid out, marked up. Hard to see from this far away, but I'll do some close-ups here. On the top. At number one, we've got a square hole there. I think you can see it. And it's 7/16 by half inch, and it's 5/8 away from the edge of the door. So then I'll just back out and go down to 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. 4 to 5, 5 to 6, and then number 6, this one's actually a square hole, half by half, and it's a half inch away from the edge of the door, which would be the back of the door. And then what I did was, I took a measurement between the holes just for another measurement to be sure. So, as you can see, it's 8 1/16 between holes from top to bottom. Okay, so moving on. Number 7, it's 3/4 away from the edge of the door, which would be the back of the door, towards the back of the car. And there's 7 to 8, 8 to 9, 9 to 10, 10 to 11, and then 11 to 12, and then number 12 centers are 7/8 from the front of the door. Okay, it's hard to see that note, but that hole right there is 5/8 wide. I don't know if it was supposed to be that way, but it is. And it's 7/8 away. So now the thing is, with these, all these ones up here, I measured them and they're 1/2 inch wide with a 1/4 inch drill bit. If you drill it in the center and then use your die grinder and widen them, is the only way I could figure to do it. So then the round holes, I measured them, and a 5/16 bit will do fine. You may have to ream them a little bit. So that's what we have for the door. So this is the right hand door. And then all you have to do is flop it around for the left-hand door, and you should be fine. This is the left side fender of the coupe, and remember, it's not an SS. So the difference being these holes right here, holes 8, 9, and 10 are not on an SS. So this is coupe only. So if you're doing an SS, this isn't going to work. So don't drill these holes. And I went ahead and numbered them like the others. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then 8, 9, 10. A little bit of glare there, but you can see them. Also, this one has 2 holes for the emblem. Okay, so here's the layout of the left front fender. A little bit of glare, but you can see it. So there's number 1, and 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5. 5 to 6. 6 to 7. Now, I didn't take a measurement on 7 to the front lip of the fender because that's bent. So, you have to go from the right side of it. Okay, so here is the holes for the left fender emblem. The center of the first hole to the back of the fender is 13 1/4, and they are 1 1/16 center to center with a 3/16 hole, and it's a little bit loose, so if you had a 13/64 bit, that would be fine, but either one would be fine. You can loosen them up a little bit. And this is where the lower, smaller trim mounts on a coupe. So the first hole, number 8, is 1 7/8 from the end of the fender, which would be the back. And then between 8 and 9, you have 6 9/16. Between 9 and 10, you have 6 9/16. And then from 10 to the end of the fender well, you have 5 inches. So those are the measurements for the left fender. Well, that's the way I've laid out my 1964 Impala Coupe body side molding trim holes. Hopefully it's helpful. If you have any questions, please hit me up in the comments and I'll try and answer them as best I can. It's really the first time I've done this. I've taken a lot of pictures, so if you have any need for pictures of this, hit me up on Facebook Messenger and I'll send them to you that way. Or hit me up in the comments and we'll work out a way to get them to you. So, like I say, hopefully it's helpful, and good luck on your 64 Impalas.